Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you the difference between stateful and stateless protocol, along with their advantages and disadvantages. So let's get started. Both stateful and stateless are the two types of network protocols. The word state here refers to the condition or the quality of being available at a given point of time. And whether a protocol is stateful or stateless depends on the length of the interaction a client has with it and how much of the information is stored. Further, when it comes to the definitions of each, both stateful and stateless have a form of mutually reliant relationship. To understand one, you must understand the other as well. And for the same, let us understand the topic of stateful versus stateless protocol in this video. Starting with, what is stateful? Here, to understand what stateful is, let's consider a scenario of a telephone call. In this case, the connection is maintained from the beginning to the end of the call to ensure continuous communication. The connection is validated first, and only then will the session be established indefinitely until the end of the talk. This is exactly what a stateful protocol is. If a client delivers a request to the server in a stateful protocol, it expects a response of some sort. And if it does not receive a response, it will send the request again. However, the major feature of stateful is that it maintains the state of all its session, be it an authentication session or a client's request for information. Stateful are those that may be used repeatedly, such as online banking or email. They are carried out in the context of prior transaction in which the states are stored, and what happened in previous transactions may have an impact on the current transaction as well. Because of this, stateful apps use the same servers every time they perform a user request. One example of stateful is FTP or file transfer protocol, as it often includes many data transfers, and in this, once the client establishes a control connection, the data transfer can easily take place. Next, let's discuss some of the advantages of stateful protocol. Number 1, they can improve performance when data retrieval is required only once. Number 2, they keep a track of the connection information and as a result delivers superior performance because they continually keep a track of the information. Number 3, stateful protocols are more intuitive because they can maintain data on the server between two requests. Next, now that we know the advantages, let's learn about the disadvantages of a stateful protocol. Number 1, these protocols are highly dependent on server-side state. Number 2, stateful protocols require memory allocation in order to store data. Number 3, usually stateful protocols require backing storage. Number 4, here, as the state is maintained, stateful is not very secure. Number 5, in the event of inefficient maintenance of session storage, there can be a decrease in the performance and it also requires continuous management of services full life cycle. Next, now that we know about what are stateful protocols, let's understand what is a stateless protocol. Here again, for a better understanding, let us consider the event of sending an SMS. In such event, the receiver's availability is not confirmed and the sender just sends the SMS to the recipient. So there is no confirmation from the receiving device to the sending device that the message has been received. And do note that despite being transmitted, there is no knowing that communication may or may not be received fully. Further, there can be no cross-verification of status or any retries. This is what stateless is all about. So, we can say that a stateless protocol is the one in which the receiver is not required to keep session state from previous request. The sender sends relevant session state to the receiver in such a way that each request may be interpreted without reference to prior request session state, which the receiver retains. One example of stateless protocol is HTTP or Hypertext Transfer Protocol, as here each request is executed independently of the request that came before it. This implies that once a transaction is completed, the connection between the browser and the server is also terminated. Now that we understand what stateless protocol is, let's look into a few of the advantages of stateless protocols. Number 1, as we just discussed, in a stateless protocol, each individual communication is unconnected and distinct from the ones that came before or after it. Number two, since the monitoring system does not have to look beyond a single request to determine the whole nature, visibility of the protocol is improved. Number three, here, each packet of data travels on its own, and there is no need to refer to another packet in these packets. Number four, the server does not have to store session state between requests. Hence, scalability is enhanced as deploying the services to any number of servers is possible and implementation is simplified even more. Number five, it is easier to recover from partial failures like crashes since no state is maintained, which improves reliability. Next, let's look into the disadvantages of stateless protocols. Number one, they are inherently less capable as they do not store any information about a particular user's session. Number two, it may be essential to include additional information in each request, and as a result, the server will need to interpret this new information every time it is received. Number three, they may degrade network performance by increasing the amount of repetitive data delivery tasks in the series of requests, which cannot be saved and reused. Next, now that we know what stateful and stateless protocols are, let's summarize the differences between stateless and stateful protocols. Number one, stateful protocols require the server to save the state of a process, whereas stateless protocols do not need the server to save the state of a process. Number two, in stateful, a server is required to store and save status information and details of a session, whereas no such server is needed for data storage in stateless protocols. Number three, in stateful, server and client are tightly coupled and are extremely interdependent on each other, whereas in stateless, server and client are more independent and hence loosely coupled. Next, number four, stateful protocols are logically heavy to implement, whereas stateless protocols are easier to implement. Number five, stateful protocols react only by the current state of a transaction or request, whereas stateless ones act independently by taking the previous or the next request into consideration. Number six, stateful expects a response and if no answer is received, the request is resent, whereas in stateless, the client sends a request to a server, which the server responds to based on the state of the request. Number seven, scaling architecture is difficult and complex when it comes to stateful, whereas it is relatively easier to scale architecture in stateless protocols. Number eight, stateful protocols are difficult to code as one of the salient features here is data storage, whereas it is much easier to code stateless protocols. Number nine, examples of stateful include protocols like Telnet and FTP, whereas examples of stateless include HTTP, UDP, which stands for User Datagram Protocol, DNS, which stands for Domain Name System, and REST APIs, etc. Lastly, to answer the big question, is stateless better than stateful? I'll say that for most cases, yes, stateless is better option when compared to stateful. However, in the end, it all comes down to your requirement. If you only require information in a transient, rapid, and of a temporary manner, stateless is the way to go. Stateful, on the other hand, might be the ideal option if your app requires more memory of what happens from one session to the next. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.